Let me tell you, one of the things I think I have figured out is my workout routine that has me loving my figure more than ever. But something that's a variable that makes me really unsettled, especially as I approach my wedding day, is the fear of bloat. Yeah, you can look amazing, but if you feel bloated, No, ma'am. In this video, I'm gonna cover some very surprising things that can actually contribute to bloat and what you can do about it. As with every video, this is gonna be to the point. And as I'm realizing, I think my channel should probably be called Random with Rachel, because the topics I cover are relatively random, but it's topics that are interesting that I think you'll probably find interesting. And you can just think of me as your girlfriend that's just giving you the scoop on the latest stuff that I'm learning about. Let's get into the tips. This one is unexpected. How about don't drink coffee first thing in the morning? Why? What? How could you, Rachel? Did you know that having coffee first thing in the morning not only drives up your cortisol, but also your estrogen levels, and it also contributes to bloat? Instead of drinking coffee first thing in the morning, yes, you can still have your coffee. Try having warm lemon water first, or you can have a ACV with water drink. That's really just gonna help your stomach, help your digestion first thing in the morning. And my dietitian Amanda refers to this as a gut elixir. It really does make a difference, not only with how bloated you are, but also your consistent digestion, which we all want. We all want. I don't care who you are. This tip's an obvious one. Stay hydrated. Even though it's obvious, still gotta remind you. Not only will it help you with bloat, it'll help your skin, it'll help just your digestion, everything. My dad was actually telling me about this story of a doctor that was a prisoner in Iran, and of course he was there with fellow inmates, and when other inmates would come to him with different issues like headaches and stomach issues and ulcers and these different things, he didn't have much he could prescribe them, right? Because he's an inmate. But what he would do was prescribe them to drink more water. And by doing that, it made a big difference in all the different issues they had. So no matter what's going on for you, whether it's bloat, skin issues, being tired, drinking more water can be a big help. In line with that, if you're bloated, you want to kick soda to the curb. Soda water, diet soda, sugar soda, 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 soda. Those bubbles are causing bloat. Gosh, there is nothing I like more than the bite of a soda water or even a Diet Coke. I know it's horrible for you, but I love it. But you know, I don't love bloat, so I still have soda water now and then. Every now and then I'll have a Diet Coke, especially if I'm gonna have some pizza. But leading up to my wedding day, not gonna have any soda. This is something new I didn't know about, but very exciting, and something you can implement in your nightly routine, especially like your wind down routine, and that's peppermint tea. This is a money tip. Like, it's awesome, and it's cheap, and it's enjoyable. So peppermint tea helps de-bloat you. This is a big category in itself that can contribute to bloat, and that's how you eat. So when you're eating your meal, try to avoid drinking with your meal. That can actually contribute to bloat. If you are thirsty, try and just limit it to sips, or just if you stay hydrated throughout the day, you probably won't need as much hydration during your meal anyhow. Another tip when it comes to eating, chew your food well. Chew it well. You think about it, the more you chew your food, the less work your stomach has to do to break things down, and it's going to reduce your bloat. Another point within eating is eat in a relaxed state. This is something I gotta revisit, but there's a lot of times where I'm rushed, I'm in the middle of the workday, I'm like eating at my kitchen counter, standing, stressed out, anxious, mindlessly eating. Not good for reducing bloat. So eat in a relaxed state, chew your food, put your fork down, breathe between bites, you know, the basics of mindful eating. I'm going to link a book that's one of my favorites, and that's The Rules of Normal Eating. I try and tell anybody and everybody who's had some type of challenges with food. It's something I've read repeatedly, and I still revisit the material. It's awesome. Speaking of food, foods that contribute to bloat, some of them are actually surprising. I did not realize that avocado and eggs actually contribute to bloat, something that I was having most mornings. Also, what contributes to bloat? Onions. Garlic. And you may be thinking, oh, I don't have onions and garlic that much. Well, if you look at your seasonings, they may be packed with those ingredients. I know I love adding taco seasoning to my salads, and I'm sure you guessed it, it's full of garlic and onions. So try and avoid that. For me, if I am gonna have something like that, I just try and put more emphasis on the way I eat. I figure that'll kind of help balance out what those culprits can do. But if you're preparing for a big day, you really wanna feel lean and svelte and not bloated, then avoid onion and garlic for certain. And then, of course, the known culprits, cruciferous vegetables, beans. If you do have to have those things, there's different digestive enzymes that can help break that down too. Because, you know, we've got to live. Somewhat of an obvious tip, but it's easy to forget, and that's the importance of moving. Whether that's doing the workout you like to do, or even things like walking. Fiber, what a sexy topic. Fiber also helps reduce bloating, but be careful, you don't want to have too much. It can backfire. But one source of fiber I've been loving, and I learned it from Jennifer Fisher. She designs jewelry. She's on an anti-inflammatory diet. She has all sorts of awesome recipes. I learned about something called basil seeds from her. And sometimes if I need to wait to have breakfast because I'm going to work out, I'll even soak some basil seeds, drink that down, get my fiber, be satiated, not feel too full for my workout. And oh my gosh, let me tell you, it's great fiber. If you know what I mean. If you're experiencing a lot of bloat, you may want to consult with your doctor about getting prebiotics and probiotics. The prebiotics are the things that can feed the healthy bacteria in your gut, and the probiotics are the bacteria themselves. So having both can make a big difference to get that gut biome in a good place. And then, of course, an obvious one, and that is excess sodium. So take a look at the things you're eating. Sometimes that sodium can be snuck in there. Avoid things with excess sodium. So those are the things that have been helping me so much lately when it comes to reducing bloat. Also, every now and then I will take the supplement called Array, which helps with reducing bloat. But I think these tips that are more lifestyle related are just as good. So out of these tips, which one stood out to you most? And what tips do you have that help you reduce bloat? Would love to see those in the comments below. As always, thank you for watching, liking, subscribing, commenting. I so appreciate it. With that, happy de-bloating. Thanks.